Hello students, I hope you all are keeping very fine at your home and studying very well. Today I am going to start chapter 2, Commercial Organizations. Commercial Organizations, it is an institutional arrangement to conduct any type of business activity. It is the foundation upon which the whole management structure is built. Now, we will learn about forms of commercial organization. Firstly, commercial organization is divided into three parts, that is private sector, public sector and joint sector. Joint sector is the combination of private and public sector. Okay. Private sector is again subdivided into sole proprietorship, partnership, corporate organization, cooperative society. We will be reading about this later. Public sector is divided into departmental organization, public corporation and government companies, whereas joint sector is divided into without foreign investment and with foreign investment. Now, we will be learning about sole proprietorship, that is the part of a private sector. The word sole means single, so it can be also pronounced as single proprietorship. We can also tell it in different name, that is single proprietorship. It is a form of business that is owned, managed and controlled by an individual. It is also called a single ownership or single proprietorship. So here the business is owned by only one person. Okay. Characteristics of sole proprietorship form of business. From your textbook you can see many points are there, but I have selected some important points which you can go through. Capital contribution, management and control, unlimited liability, flexibility in operations, free from legal formalities, distribution of profit, trade secrecy. For this, you can follow your textbook page number 33. Now I am explaining these points one by one. Capital contribution. In capital contribution, here the proprietor alone has to arrange for necessary capital and other assets essential for starting and subsequent operation of his business. Okay. So here the proprietor has to arrange its capital and other assets itself only for starting its business. Management and control. The proprietor has full authority over the affairs of the business. He is free to take decisions. That means the whole business is managed and controlled by the proprietor himself. Okay. Unlimited liability. The liability of proprietor is always comprehensive and unlimited. He is liable for the debts and loans of business. If the assets of the business are not sufficient to meet the liabilities, in that case, his personal property can be attached. So, it means that the liability of a proprietor is unlimited. So, if he is not able to clear his debts and loans, no, what will happen? He has to pay it from his personal property. Okay, so here the liability is unlimited. Next, free from legal formalities. A sole proprietor is free from any legal formalities to be complied within the establishment of the business, unlike the companies and all. Okay. Distribution of profit. The sole proprietor receives all profit of his business alone. Since he is taking all the risk also alone, no? So mind it, he will be getting all the profits of his business alone. Moreover, he bears all the losses of the business also himself. Flexibility in operation. A sole proprietor enjoys the maximum flexibility in his business. He can easily change, expand or reduce business according to his discretion. Obviously, we can understand students because it is flexible in operation as only one person is involved here. So, he can take his decisions on his own. He can expand it. He can reduce it. He can change it. Whatever he wants, he can do it. Okay. So, it is flexible in operation. Next, trade secrecy. Since only one person is involved here, no? So the proprietor keeps all his trade secrets only to him. In this way, he avoids competitors by retaining business secrets. Okay? Advantages of sole proprietorship of business. Sole proprietorship of business has following advantages, which is also from your textbook. You can see there. Easy formation, prompt decisions, incentives for hard work, maintenance of business secrecy, intimate contacts with customers, inexpensive management, efficiency in management, minimum government regulations, tax advantage, बेनिफिट ऑफ हेरिडिटरी गुडविल. द सोल प्रोप्राइटरशिप बिजनेस कैन बी एस्टैब्लिश्ड वेरी इजीली. नो लीगल फॉर्मेलिटी और अदर कॉम्प्लिकेटेड प्रोसीजर इज रिक्वायर्ड टू बी फॉलोड. अ पर्सन कैन स्टार्ट बिजनेस ऑपरेशन एज एंड वेन ही डिजायर्ड. ओके, ओनली अ लाइसेंस इज नीडेड इन सम केसेज लाइक ओपनिंग अ वाइन शॉप एक्सेट्रा. प्रॉम्प्ट डिसीजंस. सिंस आई हैव एक्सप्लेन यू अर्लियर डैट इट इज फ्लेक्सिबल इन ऑपरेशन इजंट इट, हियर द प्रोप्राइटर इज अलोन वर्किंग नो, सो ही कैन टेक क्विक डिसीजंस रिगार्डिंग द बिजनेस अफेयर्स. ही कैन टेक स्पॉट डिसीजंस एज एंड वेन रिक्वायर्ड. इंसेंटिव्स फॉर हार्ड वर्क. देर इज ऑलवेज अ डायरेक्ट रिलेशनशिप बिटवीन द एफर्ट्स एंड रिवर्ड्स इन केस ऑफ अ सोल प्रोप्राइटरशिप. सिंस द पर्सन इज इन्वॉल्व अलोन, वॉट एवर ही विल वर्क, हाउ मच हार्ड वर्क ही विल डू, he will earn more. Okay, so it provides incentives to work hard, efficiently and honestly. Maintenance of business secrecy. As explained earlier, a proprietor can maintain secrecy regarding his business as he has not to consult anyone on business decisions. Okay, intimate contacts with customer. The proprietor develops close and personal contacts with his customers. This enables him to cater to the exact requirements of his customer. Inexpensive management. The management of a sole proprietor is not expensive at all. All supervisory and management activities are performed by the proprietor himself. Thus, it minimizes the additional expenditure on managerial staff. When, mind it, when there is big firms, means big type of, means not sole proprietorship, it is company or partnership. Here what happens? You need manager, supervisor, okay? So, in sole proprietorship, there is no expense of the supervisor and managers, etc. Thus, it minimizes the additional expenditure on managerial staff. Next is efficiency in management. The proprietor's personal interest is involved in his business. He tries his heart and soul to eliminate all sorts of wastages in order to reduce cost and maximize profits. Okay. Then, minimum government regulations. The business activities of a sole proprietor are least regulated by law and government. A sole proprietorship business has to comply with mainly labor laws and tax laws. Okay. Tax advantage. A sole proprietorship business enjoys the minimum tax burden as compared to other forms of business organization. Here the tax burden is minimum. A proprietor is taxed as an individual and not as a business unit separately. Benefit of hereditary goodwill. The goodwill of the business earned by a person during his lifetime also passes from generation to generation till it is closed. Thus, a sole proprietor can enjoy the benefits of his goodwill, of the hereditary goodwill. Okay, that means if there is a goodwill of the business, of the sole proprietorship business, then that goodwill will pass from generation to generation. Okay. Now we will come to demerits of sole proprietorship. Demerits of sole proprietorship business are unlimited liability and risk, limited financial resources, limited managerial capability, instability of the business, uncertainty in purchase and sales, limited scope for employees. See, there are many points in your textbook. You can go through those points also. Okay. Now, follow page number 36. Unlimited liability and risk. The principles of unlimited liability for the owner puts the proprietor at great risk in times of losses. You know what is unlimited liability? In the features I explained, you know that if a single proprietor or sole proprietor is not able to pay his debts and loans on time, then his personal property can be also taken to clear his debts. So here the liability is unlimited. Since there is the principle of unlimited liability, it puts the proprietor at great risk in times of losses. So if the proprietor gets the losses, he is in great risk because he will be haunted due to the fear of losing his private property in case of failure of his business. Okay. Next, limited financial resources. The capital and the other resources of an individual are always limited. Therefore, there appears to be a limited capacity of expansion of business operations. Since here the financial means we know na one person is there involved there. So his capital and other resources will be limited only. That's why what happens? It doesn't get the capacity to expand the business. Limited managerial capability. It is not possible for a single individual to possess expertise in all fields. That means a single individual is involved in sole proprietorship, so he is not expert in all field like production, finance, marketing, etc. So the decisions of the proprietor may not be balanced due to limited managerial ability. Instability of the business. The continuity and existence of a sole proprietorship form of business is the most uncertain. Any uncertain event happening in the personal life of a property are surely to disturb the smooth working of the business. Since only one person is involved here, we can see the business can become unstable. Why? When there is any uncertainty in the personal life of proprietor. So it will disturb that business. Uncertainty in purchase and sales. The proprietor is unable to get the advantage of bulk purchase and increased sales as he carries on the business on a small scale. Limited scope for employees. A sole proprietor cannot attract trained and qualified persons for reasons of limited career opportunities. Moreover, a proprietor cannot offer financial incentives to attract skilled employees because its activities are on a small scale. Thank you.